Hallo. Hallo. Hallo.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you good.
All right, cool. What's going on? First off, I want to address something that you said.
Go ahead.
I addressed the person who said Tommy going out bad. He a failure. I said, so you're on a person's channel who at this current moment has 600 people watching them live. I will have 3,000. So if I'm a failure at doing this, then what would you call the person who has less than me? That would make sense, wouldn't it? That would be like somebody for having a 4-bedroom house standing in a person's house who has 1-bedroom. That's a silly argument. I don't know these people, and they're making dumbass arguments saying things like that.
Okay, but I didn't make that statement.
And I didn't say it to you. I said it back to that person. Right.
Yeah, but you said right. So if you notice, you said I want to address something that you said. That's what you said in the beginning.
No. I want to address something that was said.
Okay.
You said something about it during. You said something about it during the show. You said it and then tried to come at me. I don't give a damn if
no.
I got 20. I'm still somebody. I was talking to the person.
Yeah, but I wasn't talking.
They're dissing you.
Yeah, but
they're dissing you. If they say I'm a failure. Then by logic, it would be like saying Kwame Brown's a failure for being the number one draft pick, making only averaging 6 points a game. And you're saying it in front of a person who was the number one draft pick, and he only averaged 3 points a game. It's a weird argument.
Well, it would be a weird argument for me because I wasn't the one that created it, and nor did I see it in the comment section. The moment that you was even called crispy, I told them to delete that immediately. So
no,
I showed you
you responded to it on
that. I don't think that you're a failure, not at all. I think that actually you're emotional. I think that you emotionally reacted today, and I think that you could have presided over this situation a lot better than what you did. That's what I think.
Well, first off, a lot of people can say a lot of things about how someone reacted, how they made all those videos about you being someone underage. Everyone
right.
can react different. I would have said I would have reacted to that completely different.
Right.
So when someone says you're emotional, you were emotional then.
Okay, well, let me.
In response to what people are saying.
I'm going to wait till you finish so I can respond.
Well, I was just saying, by that logic, you're emotional then. For someone to tell a black man that apparently he ain't supposed to be emotional, be off of emotions. I don't like the fact that y'all keep mischaracterizing, and I hate that crap. It's my show. My show's there for a reason. If you ain't gonna watch it, don't speak on it. Y'all, Tommy's mad because he ain't giving him his credit. I literally said in my video what it was. So y'all just making up videos and talking about things that aren't true. He told me he was going to do something. My whole video was about a man of integrity. If I told you I'm going to call into this show, or if I'm gonna, if I told you, hell, hey man, I'm gonna hook up with you on Wednesday, and say you told people, hey, Tommy, gonna come on the show on Wednesday.
Right.
If I don't know, but I'm on somebody else's show, how would you feel about it? I told you I'm gonna do it as a man of integrity.
Well, I mean, that wasn't my argument. It's not so much of what I was.
But that
feel.
Was my argument.
Hold on.
My argument.
I listen.
That's
hold on,
what
hold
my
on.
Show is about.
Hold on. I listen to you. Let me speak. That's not my argument. I'm saying that you just could have presided over that situation differently. I wasn't telling you that you shouldn't have feelings or an emotion towards it, but to allow it to govern you to the point where you went live about it when that's something that you could have handled over
well,
the phone.
Hold on. Do you know
and to go back to that situation, even with the minor, I wasn't on the internet in my feelings. I don't know where you got that from.
Well, what did I, you said that could have been handled differently. How did I handle it?
The way that you handled it was you went to the internet about it.
You said
and,
I could
have
reached out
we
to
wouldn't have,
but
hold
I
on,
did.
Let me say this.
Let me say this.
The only reason why we're talking about it now is because you ran to the internet.
No. Well, whenever you ran to the internet. But okay, but you
I could,
ran
I wouldn't have been able to know about
ran, you ran to
Tommy.
The
I wouldn't even know about the Discord between you, Tommy. Tommy,
right, and there's
I wouldn't even known God. About the Discord between you and him if you had never went to the internet.
I agree.
Okay.
I agree. Here's the difference. You won't agree that by logic of what you're saying, yes, I ran to the internet with my business. You then, within seconds, ran to the internet with two.
I was reaping off the benefits of you being a god queen. You know what I mean? What about a
so
man's
it's different
business?
When you're doing it. Well, I made more money than you. I'm talking about my own situation.
Of course, you made more money about your situation.
Exactly.
It's your
so
it's
you
your situation.
Act like what you did was business, and what I did wasn't.
No, but see, but this is the thing. See, you're in a trick world, and your world, you know what I mean? It's the whole money thing, nigga. I had money before I came to YouTube.
I had money before I came to YouTube. I don't know why you're trying to sell.
Yeah, but you're trying to. Yeah, but you're trying to bring something to me. But you was nothing in the streets in comparison to me. So we're two different. We're two different. We're two different. We're two different guys.
You and me.
We're two different people.
I get on the internet and try to act like I was
no,
something else
we're two,
and try to damn
yes, you
somebody
did.
Else. I don't know what you did.
No, yes, you
I just
did.
Know you're up in Canada.
No, no, I just know that you.
Is you did. So
no, I just know that you sit up. Hold on, hold on.
You don't know what I was in the street.
Hold on, hold on.
Because I guarantee you come to these streets.
Hold on. If I guarantee you this, I guarantee you that you wouldn't say this face to face. I guarantee you that you would have the same energy that you had when you got punched in your face at that motherfucking event. That's what I know. I know you wouldn't be hollering and screaming up in my face. I know that you're comfortable in your little house, you know what I mean, saying what you said over the phone. But face to face, you wouldn't have that same energy. You would be just like an in-pocket bitch in my presence. That's what the fuck you would be. You and we was face to face, you would be in pocket like the perfect little bottom bitch, the way that you was at Sonetta's event when you got your ass punched in the motherfucking mouth and you spoke in the language of silence. You humbled your motherfucking self. And not only did you do that, you didn't want to sit up there and fight. You sit up there and jumped on the motherfucking phone and called the police with your white clef. Someone please call 911 ass. That's what the fuck happened to you. So stop trying to talk to me like you a thug or you a gangster or you with the shit because you don't have one street bone in your trick ass body. You are a trick to me. You are a motherfucking enemy against your own goddamn message. You understand? You gonna talk all of that shit about black women and then sit up there and trick on the same motherfucking thoughts, you understand me, that you talk about. So sit your motherfucking ass down. And you want to speak on minors? Nigga, what motherfucking nigga sit up there and come in the room with a towel on, you understand me, in front of his fucking daughter? Nigga, you created a lot of the drama that even comes your fucking way. You understand me? So nigga, don't be sitting over here trying to sit up there over scream me and over talk me. I sit up there and gave your motherfucking sissified ass a chance to sit up there and speak your peace of mind. But when you sit up there and went left field, now I gotta rebuke your motherfucking trick ass. Nigga, stop it. If we was face to face, you wouldn't be doing none of that. And you know that. Had to. But nigga, try to sit up there and bring that slick shit and bring up the motherfucking case and all of that when you sitting up here taking towels off and shit, you know what I mean, in front of your daughter. Nigga, go live, nigga. You fucking YouTuber. You know what I mean? Nigga is a fucking YouTuber. You understand me? Went to the internet about the shit. That's what my argument was. It wasn't about, you know, the child shit.